Hello kids, now we have already done the topic flower, and by the time we know that the parts of flower are sepals, petals, stamen and pistil. Out of these, sepals and petals are protective and they also help in pollination, whereas pistil and stamen, that is female and male part, these are the male reproductive organs that directly are involved in the act of fertilization. The egg is formed here inside the ovary and it will be fertilized here by the male gamete that will be brought by pollen tube. So since we have a knowledge of all this, let us start with pollination. What is pollination? Pollination is simply the transfer of pollen grains from the opened anther, from one flower, to the receptive stigma of the carpel of either the same flower or different flower. So in simple language, we can say that pollination refers to the phenomena or the process of passing or transferring the male gametes or pollen grains with the male gametes from one flower to the stigma of the other. Now there are two types of pollinations. Say you call it self-pollination or cross-pollination. Now let's investigate these two. Now see, when the pollen grains from the anther of one flower fall on the stigma of the same flower, there only, it is self-pollination. Or another condition where the pollen grains from the anther of one flower falls on the stigma of another flower but of the same plant, that is also called self-pollination, because all the flowers which are born on these stems and branches, that is this plant, they all will be similar genetically. So either the pollen grains are transferred from the stamens to the stigma of the same flower or of the different flower of the same plant, it will be designated as self-pollination. Whereas if you are transferring the pollen grains from one plant to the other, it is cross-pollination. That is, flower that is born on one plant to the flower that is born on another plant of the same species, of course, that is known as cross-pollination. The species should be same. There can be mild, very mild and minor variations. And to show that only, I have changed the color of the flower a bit, slight, so that you should understand that there can be variations, okay, in these two plants, but they should belong to the same species. So when the flower from one plant transfers its pollen grains to the flower of another plant, that is known as cross-pollination. Now there are certain differences that we encounter due to this particular act. Let us see what differences do we see. Self-pollination involves the transfer of pollen grains to the stigma of the same flower or different flower of same plant. I have underlined same plant to tell you that it is important to note that plant is same, because it will reinforce the knowledge that they are genetically similar. Okay. Whereas here in the cross pollination, the transfer of pollen grains take place from one plant to the other. So another plant is important to note down. Now, self-pollination is causing or is letting the pollen grains fall on the flowers of the same plant. And so the flowers are quite nearby. So that is why it would not need any external agency to allow the pollen grains to be transferred. They can simply fall off. While the stamen opens and ruptures, the pollen grains are thrown in under force and they can easily reach the stigma either of the same flower or different flower because they are on the same plant. So they do not require external agency, nothing from outside, to transfer the pollen grains. Whereas in cross pollination, the plants could be very distantly placed. It could be 5 kilometers, 1 kilometer or whatever. So the pollen grains are needed to be carried away from one plant to the other. So you require a facilitator or a pollinator, and that is why you require a vector, and that is why cross-pollination requires certain external agency. Like you have seen an insect sitting here, while insect is taking the nectar, It would be rubbing its body, carrying the pollen grains on its backside or on its wings. When it will fly and go to another plant, which happens to be of the same species, the pollen grains will be dusted or will be, falling on the stigma of the flower. And this is how pollen grains will reach to the stigma of another plant, which may be very far off. Okay. So you require an external agency for that. Then this requires the production of small number of, small quantity of pollen grains, because the pollen grains have to be distributed in a limited area of the same plant. So not many are required, because not many are wasted. Okay. So that is why lesser energy is, spent, because less pollen grains are formed. But the plants that are taking up cross-pollination, there more energy is actually input, because they make more pollen grains so that there can be assurance that if many of them would perish, few of them will be able to reach some of the other flowers which are present on some other plants. The last point is actually very important. They do not bring variation. And I have already told you why. Because they are genetically similar. But this kind of transaction would bring about a lot of variations. Because supposingly you have flower color of this type and this type. This is also yellow, but a bit of reddish yellow. Now what would happen? The new progeny will be different from these, because it will be carrying a gene from here and a gene from here. So this is how variations are introduced. This happens at so many metabolic activities level. This is going to be giving a chance to the new embryo formed, a chance to the new plant formed, to be showing its own variation from the parent plants. So variation is introduced when you have cross-pollination. Whereas in self-pollination, mostly, by and large, you have the photocopy kind, because they are having the same genetic constitution throughout. That is why you have same kind of plant. Almost same kind of characteristics are there.